Directly behind them began in a loud voice. "Why don't you talk American? You live here, don't you? You make your living here. Talk American." One of the men turned to glance at her, and the two went on talking in Greek or Italian, calmly, quietly, although every now and then the woman cried out, "American, why don't you?" These men were Jews, I thought. How uneasy they would have become, and their faces would show it. One of them might even say to the woman, if he knew enough English, "This is a free country, isn't it?" The two men, however, continued to talk as they'd been doing, and neither turned to glance at the woman, or show by gesture or grimace that they had heard her. Finally, she jumped up and sat down next to me. "What do you think of these men?" she said. "Why don't they talk American?" "They live here, don't they? They make their money here." "You must not be so impatient," I said. "English is not an easy language to learn. Besides, if they don't learn it, their children will. We have good schools here." She looked at me suspiciously. When the bus stopped, hurrying off, fleeing our contamination. One of the men then turned to me and said quietly, in the best of American, not a trace of a foreign accent, "She's a little cracked.